Olivia had been rescued from the clutches of her stepbrother Tristan by the absolute evil. This seemed a bit surprising as, after all, Talia had accidentally caused its demise only one cutscene earlier. But the disembodied essence of the irritated evil was restless due to its lack of physical form. It needed help finding a new body. In such cases, less competent personnel were also called upon. Talia was extremely grateful to have been freed from the cage after three long missions. Finding a new body for the absolute evil seemed a small price to pay. High up on the fourth highest peak in the world, Mount Snotmore resided the venerable Council of Little Snots. These wise beings were the ones who would know what would constitute a new, adequate vessel for the absolute evil. All Talia had to do was reach the peak. A trifle, really, but unfortunately, her stupid stepbrother and his oversized army stood between her and her goal. Otherwise, however, it would have been so easy that even a group of gluttonous hobbits could have managed it. Bad elves go everywhere. Talia had been freed from the clutches of good. Before she could start her journey to the Council of Little Snots, however, she had to first gather strength.
I am even stronger! Good! I will destroy... Give your orders!
Time for trouble!
Give your... Everything good! I will destroy this land! Give your... I am the... Good! Everything good must die!
Free at last! This travelling in a cage through the overworld really made me miss that musty, stuffy dungeon air. What exciting scent is that rising to my nose? Is it...
Ah! Okay, which one of you little snots did that?
While Talia was more or less enjoying her new freedom, her stepbrother Tristan was roaming the overworld with his entourage.
The next stone was bound to be around here somewhere, but I'm having a hard time finding my way around this foul place.
Men, we will set up camp here and drive the darkness from this place.
Tristan, again? I've really seen about enough of these relatives lately. It feels like Thanksgiving and Christmas happening back to back. And then he even dares to rid the area here of its stylish greys. Just you wait. I'll make you pay for everything.
But before Talia could arrange a reunion with her stepbrother, it was urgently necessary for her to raise a powerful army. The underground was infested with spiders who called it their home. In addition, some particularly hard layers of stone stretched through the underground. In order to dig through these layers of stone, the research-addicted evil first had to research better tools for its little snots. But this required a fair amount of evilness. One could gain a particularly great amount of evilness by defeating a good being. Like this unicorn, for example, which, by chance, of course, and completely in tune with the context of the world, currently resided here.
Kill the unicorn for an extra portion of evilness. Sounds like a great way to start the day.
The discovering evil had discovered a harder layer of rock. Its little snot's tools were not tough enough for that, and it would take them far too long to dig through the rock with their teeth. Research would enable the new technology unlocking evil to improve its little snot's tools to the point that this rock would no longer be an obstacle.
In my last war, I had the little snots dig through anything and everything. There you are, locked up for a few days, and bam! Technology starts to backslide. Dreadful.
Payday.
Now what's going on? Why is the Earth starting to shake? Volcanic eruption? Teen band concert or what?
Whatever it was, the tremors had shaken some things up in the underground. Numerous spiders woke up from their sleep and became active and hungry.
Great! Spiders again! Nobody here ever thinks about the people with arachnophobia. Well then,
forward! Prepare the dungeon! Defend the traps and oil the creatures!
Or the other way around.
The defending evil would be well advised to have its horde creatures level up faster in an arena and to assign creatures to the guard room to keep an eye out for enemies. Underground critters burst through the dungeon walls.
Destroy them! Exterminate them!
Men, we dare not fall. It's time to set up another camp. Forward!
Hey, that's not fair. I can't even get there yet. How am I supposed to stop them?
Talia and the researching evil were able to use research to make it possible for their little snots to dig through harder rock as well.
Bloody know-it-all. Fine. I'll have a look at that nerd stuff then.
Creatures are collecting their pay. A new area has been unearthed in the dungeon. To bet on illegal cage fights, evil had built an arena for its creatures. The butchering evil had destroyed the critters that had invaded the dungeon. Was that supposed to be it? Spoiler. No, that was not it.
I will destroy them!
Oh, that is, my army will destroy them, and I'll toss a few spells into the fray from behind. She's not gonna get up.
Serve us well in the fight against the Dark Hordes.
The heroes have managed to set up a camp. Henceforth, even more heroes would protect the overworld.
That thing won't be there for long. Onward, creatures! On to the overworld! Crowbars at the ready, and make that building an historic monument. Then, when we tear it down, it'll be even more evil.
Your little snots have dug up a spider.
Construction crews I see setting up.
Move out, creatures! Flatten them!
Defend the dungeon heart. Thank you. If I remember correctly, the last time a unicorn was slain was in Dungeons 2.
Are you telling boring stories from the olden days again, old man?
Just go and flatten that slithering rhinoceros already. A horde creature set about training in the arena. This provided not only satisfaction, but also valuable experience. Spider's nest disintegrated into dust under the blows of the arachnophobic evil's creatures.
Ding dong! It's payday!
A new hero camp had been built. The watchful evil had erected a guard room. Creatures could be posted there to keep an eye out for enemies.
There are enemies in your dungeon.
One of the hero's construction crews set out to build a new camp.
Dug into a spider room.
assigning creatures to guard duty evil had thrown some of its creatures into the guard room. From now on, these creatures would be there to watch for approaching enemies.
It's payday.
You've dug into a spider room. Sickening green slime oozed out of the spider's nest as it was destroyed. One of the hero's construction crews had set up a camp.
the hero's construction crews I see setting out?
Move out, creatures! Flatten them!
Enemies are in the dungeon.
I sure showed him.
Ah! Wonderful evilness.
The violent evil had had its armies destroy the good being. The evilness it had captured allowed it to now effortlessly research improved tools for its little snots. With the help of the new tools, the letting others toil evil's little snots were now able to punch their way through harder rock.
Excellent! On you go, you lazy little snots. Get to work! You're not getting paid just to loaf about.
In fact, the little snots weren't paid at all.
Ah, so what? They serve a greater cause. Pleasing me, for example. They could try to form a union or some such nonsense.
One of the hero's construction crews set out to build a new camp.
much for your construction crew, brother dear. I guess that's when the real estate bubble burst, huh?
Tanya, do you even know what the real estate bubble is and what it means?
You don't want to spoil my moment of triumph with a lot of useless knowledge, do you?
No, it's all right. What you know is a drop. What you don't know is an ocean. A new hero camp has been built. Little snots have completely mined out the gold vein. There are enemies in your dungeon. Payday! Creatures are collecting their pay. You have unearthed a new area in the dungeon. The arachnophobic evil had attacked a spider's nest on its way to the dungeon gate. Its creatures prepared to defend themselves.
By defend, I assume you mean attack, right?
Go ahead, grab 'em, smash 'em, use their legs for toothpicks.
Lost a creature forever. With a satisfying crack, one of the spider's nests shattered. Digging Evil had discovered another dungeon gate to the overworld. enemies have entered the dungeon.
It's payday.
A gold vein has been mined out. There are enemies in your dungeon. A new area has been unearthed in the dungeon. payday. Enemies have entered the dungeon.
Thank you.
A gold vein is almost exhausted. Payday. Forever. A gold vein has been mined out. Oh.
enemies have entered the dungeon. Ding dong, it's payday.
My brothers, in your eyes I see the same fear that would lead me to despair. The day may come when the true hero's fury is extinguished. When we abandon our companions and all bonds of friendship are broken. But that day is still far off. Stand fast, heroes of the West, and defend our camp!
How many times do we have to listen to this crap? He could at least have used a different line. Idiot.
Tristan's men didn't seem to mind the simple repetition. Granted, heroes were never afraid of a grind and would join a raid for the 100th time just for the chance to win a colorful hat. The heroes poured out to build new defenses. Your gold vein is nearly exhausted. The demolishing evil's creatures had destroyed one of the hero's camps.
Oops! Did my little creature break one of your little camps, brother dear? I'm so sorry about that. I hope you didn't feel the need to cry again, like you did that time with Lammy Lamb, your cuddly little sheep.
You leave Lammy Lamb out of this! My brave soldiers will rebuild this camp in no time. Just the way Grandma used to do with her needle and thread when... Whatever! You are truly vile, Talia!
Ooh, thanks for the compliment. Forward, creatures! Don't tire now! Keep going! Look for camps! Find them and wipe them off the map! Oh, no! I don't mean that literally, you knucklehead!
It's payday. Another of the heroes' camps had been destroyed. Your little snots have completely mined out a gold vein.
Construction crews I see setting up.
Move out, creatures! Flatten them!
The camp destroying evil had wiped another hero's shelter off the face of the earth.
pyramid. One of the hero's construction crews has been obliterated.
Your throne room is under attack.
Another of the hero's camps had been...
My brothers! In your eyes, I see the same fear that would lead me to despair. The day may come when the courage of true heroes is extinguished, when we abandon our companions and all bonds of friendship are broken. I wish I could stay with you, but I must continue to pursue the quest. We shall meet again.
With these words, Tristan made good his escape.
What? That coward! Come back here, you miserable little runt, so I can get back at you for the days upon days of excruciating rides in a cage!
Hero's camp was not any doom. It had already... Tanya and the cunning evil had done it. The hero's camps lay in ruins.
You got that right! Tristan! Come out, wherever you are! It's like that time I turned eight, except this time you're the piñata. Tristan? Where are you?
In her destructive frenzy, Tanya had forgotten about Tristan's somewhat precipitous departure.
Right. That freaking coward. Oh, I was so busy beating the crap out of heroes that I totally missed it. Whatever. I have to look at this ominous council of little snots anyway. I guess my revenge will have to wait. Postponed, but not abandoned.